हेलो फ्रेंड्स, इन द प्लेलिस्ट ऑफ डिस्कवरिंग स्टैटिस्टिक्स यूजिंग जमोवी टुडे आई विल टीच यू हाउ टू हैंडल द मल्टी डिकोटोमी क्वेश्चंस। मल्टी डिकोटोमी रेफर्स टू द सिचुएशन व्हेन द रिस्पोंडेंट्स आर अलाउड टू टेक मोर देन वन आंसर ऑप्शंस फॉर ए क्वेश्चन। Here is a question. For what purpose do you use internet? There are some options: email, YouTube or videos, Facebook, chatting, browsing. Let's discuss this question. Friends, suppose I ask this question from you. You may take email or don't take. Means you may say I use for email or don't use for email. Suppose question is asked from me. I may take on three options: Facebook, chatting and browsing. Means I am not taking on email and YouTube. Means a respondent may take or not take. Means dichotomy. He may say yes or no for each option. Friends, I have a questionnaire named Eating Out Habits of Individual. From this questionnaire, I have taken a question. Question is, and instructions are also given, you may tick all that apply. For what reason do you eat out? Options are: no option of home cooked food, special occasion, leisure, to spend time with friends and family. Question has been asked, a person may tick all that which apply to him. Means a respondent may tick on all the four options, three options, two options as he likes. Friends, if we discuss about the coding and levels, means for option A, no option of home cooked food, means one person can say yes or no. And same in the case of special occasion, yes or no. Leisure, yes or no. To spend time with friends and family, yes or no. Means there are two levels means dichotomy, and there are more than two options, so this is multi dichotomy. Why such questions are called multi dichotomy? Because there are more than two options, so it is multi response, and for each response there are two options, yes or no, it is dichotomy. Such questions are called multi dichotomy questions. How to handle these questions? Suppose here are answers of a respondent. He responded like this. He ticked on no option of home cooked food. Yes, he goes in such case. Special occasion, no. Leisure, yes. To spend time with friends and family, he said no. In this case, if we discuss about creating variables. This is respondent ID. We create for reference purpose. No option of cooked food in first, second column. Special occasion, leisure, to spend time with friends and family. These variable will be created in separate columns. Friend, question is one, but we have created four variables. Because for each option, I will get the answer as yes or no. Friends, if I discuss the data entry of that respondent which we have earlier discussed, he said yes for no option of home cooked food. For yes, we have taken the code as 1. Special occasion, he said no, we will write here 0. Leisure, yes, he said yes, then I am writing here 1. And to spend time with friends and family, he said no, then I am giving the code 0. In this way, we can make entry for other respondent also. Our final output will be like this. Let's discuss how to calculate this final output. Let's open the file in Jamovi. This is my file. In this file, in first column respondent ID, second column no option of home cooked food, third special occasion, fourth leisure, and to spend time with friends and family. If I double click on this, data variable view will be opened. This is of nominal scale and levels are no and yes. And for other variables we can check. Special occasion, nominal scale, no or yes. And leisure, no or yes. Nominal scale, to spend time with friends and family, no or yes. And nominal scale. Let's calculate the output for this data set. For this, we will calculate frequency distribution first. Click on analyze. In analyze, exploration, click on descriptive. Descriptive commands has been opened and this is output region. From here, from source list, I will shift no option of cooked food at home, special occasion, leisure, to spend time with my friends and family, to variables box. And check these frequencies tables. Friends, let's check in output region which type of output has been given by Jamovi. N, there are 76 respondents. No frequency has been missing. Mean median has no use for this my data set. Minimum code and maximum code. Minimum 0, maximum 1. Let's check the other output. Frequencies table. Frequency of no option of cooked food at home. Frequency for special occasion. Let's check for the first option. There are total 76 respondents, out of which 48 had replied as no and 28 had replied as yes. And there is frequency distribution, frequency of leisure, frequency of to spend time with friends and family. Right click on this table and copy the data, and after copying it, paste into Excel. I have already pasted in Excel to save the time for creating a video. Here I have pasted the data. I would like to calculate a frequency table for all these variables overall. Overall means I have written the option no option of cooked food at home. I would like to note down who had said yes. No option of home cooked food at yes means for this variable only 28 respondents. Then I will write here 28. And for special occasion there are 43. Now write here 43. And for next 26, I will write here 26. And for fourth option, to spend time with friends and family, you can check 41. Let's enter the figure 41. Okay, now our table has been ready. After this, what to do? Friends, check it carefully. There are total 76 respondents. But if we check the total of these answers, these responses, sum, if we would like to take the total by following the sum command, it is 130. How it became 138? Friends, because every respondent has option to take more than one option for such question in multi dichotomy questions, because a person may take on more than one option. There are 76 respondents, but the total responses I got as yes. The total is 138. Now I have to calculate percentage of cases. When I have to calculate percentage of cases, I will divide this figure with 138 total responses which I got as yes. Let's calculate the percentage. Is equal to 28 divided by 138. Enter 20%. Let's drag for other cells. Yes, you can check. There were four options. 31% who go out for food, eating out on special occasion, and 30% are such respondents, such persons who go to eat out to spend time with friends and family, and 20% no option of cooked food at home, and 19% only go out for leisure. Friends, in this way, we handle or we calculate frequency distribution for multi-dichotomy question. Friends, I hope this video will be useful for you. Thank you, my friends.